Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن خير الكلام كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أما بعد. Brothers and sisters in Islam, during today's khutbah I want to talk about a topic that's very important to realizing the essence of our existence in this world, which is worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Two concepts that they need to go together in our life, so our worshipping of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be on the right path. So our flying to Allah will be high. These two things, these two qualities for us, like the two wings for a bird. When they are healthy, the bird will fly high. When there is something wrong with one of the two wings, the bird cannot fly and will be an easy prey for hunters. So if any one of these two wings of ours as believers is not healthy, will be an easy prey for Satan to drive us away, that we may, that might lead us to go astray. What are these two qualities I'm talking about for us? Are the wings with which we fly to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to have balance in our flying, to steadfast in the right path. You might be wondering, these are hope and fear. Hope and fear. And it's very important to have both in balance. Now some people might say, where about love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The ulama said the love for us as believers like the head to the bird. So it has to be there. There is no love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It means we are fake. We are not believers in the first place. Like a bird having no head, it doesn't exist. It's dead. And the hope and fear for us are the two wings. So these are the three qualities for our ibadah to be true worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To remain steadfast and fly high towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in every one of these qualities, you know, people deviated, not just from our ummah, even from the people before us, who thought that we attain closeness to Allah and enter His Jannah by just having love. Just love God. Love Jesus. Because they believe Jesus is God. By having love, irrespective of the evil and the sins the person commits in this life, love is enough. And the person will go to Jannah. Even among the Muslims, there were and there are deviant sects who subscribe to this wrong belief. Hope, when you think of those who claim to be the chosen people, the promised people, they have that hope. And God will treat them differently irrespective of the sins and the evil they commit on earth. And that was a false hope among this ummah, people who live by false hope. So to have worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a true sense, in a way that will draw us closer to Allah, we need to maintain balance between these two qualities. And there are too many verses in the Quran that shows us maintaining the balance between the two, having two together are very essential. وَادْعُوهُ خَوْفًا وَطَمَعًا. Call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is the ibadah, calling on Allah with hope and fear. And too many verses around this meaning. In this regard, I want you with me to go through a quick journey pondering and contemplating the opening chapter in the Quran, that which we recite every day minimum 17 times, where we can see these meanings in it. Very important, ya jama'ah. So when we recite this surah, we should taste the message in it. When we recite the first verse in Surah Al-Fatiha, what's the first verse? Allah Azza wa Jal says, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. All praise and thanks for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord, the Rabb of the worlds. Now the word Rabb in Arabic, in Quran, is translated in English by the word the Lord. But in reality, this translation is not given, not doing enough explanation for the meaning the word Rabb carries in it. Rabb in Arabic means Allah, the Creator, the one who created, who creates, who sustains, who nourishes, who gives, who provides for us, who takes care of us, who looks after us. So all the blessings in our life, the family, the shelter, the wealth, the health, and on top of all of that, the guidance to the right path, all that are from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now by Allah, every time you and I recite this verse, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, reminding ourselves with the blessings of Allah being our Rabb, who takes care of us, who looks after us, who provides for us, who nourishes us, who loves us. Within that create reminds us of the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya ikhwani wa lillahi al-mathalu al-a'la, and the best of example belongs to Allah. When someone does something good to us, a kind of kindness, an act of kindness, or present a gift to us, don't we feel indebted to them? Don't we feel inclined with love towards them for that good they did to us? How about Allah, the Rabb, who's taking care of us? So the first verse of Surah Al-Fatiha is about the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then we read the second verse, which is Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Now the way it's translated in English, the most merciful, the most gracious, or the vice versa. But the true meaning of these two qualities of Allah, two attributes of Allah, these two names of Allah, Ar-Rahman, it means that Allah Azza wa Jal, His attribute, His essence, His nature, if you will, is mercy. Ar-Rahim, it means that in all of his actions, there is mercy. So when you think of these two attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he is Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, wouldn't that fill up our hearts with hope that whatever we do in this life, because we are sinners, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, if you were not to sin, if you are immune of sinning, Allah Azza wa Jal will take you away, bring other group of people who are sinning and turning to Allah in repentance, and Allah Azza wa Jal will forgive them. So that's part of our nature as a human being. So when we remember, when we recite every time Surah Al-Fatiha and our prayer, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, it keeps and fill up our hearts with hope that Allah Azza wa Jal, with all of His mercy and graciousness, He will take care of us. He will forgive our sins, provided we do our homework. Now the concept of raja, hope in Islam, is very important. Now when you read these verses in the Quran, for example, that there is hope in it, as an attribute of the believer, you will always find with the hope that they are doing actions, they are doing righteous deeds. They come together all the time in the Quran. Meaning, for our hope to be meaningful, to draw us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it should be accompanied by righteous deeds, should be accompanied by actions that draws us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned His slaves in Surah Al-Sajda, تَتَجَافَى جُنُوبُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَضَاجِعِ, that their backs, their sides are feeling, you know, away from their beds, they are not sleeping at night, يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ خَوْفًا وَطَمَعًا, that they are standing at night praying to Allah with hope and fear. So the hope here is accompanied by standing at night in prayer. Then Allah Azza wa Jal said after this, وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. So it's not just about hoping, it's about acting, it's about doing righteous deeds along with the hope. That's true hope. Therefore the ulama said there are three types of hope. Two of them are praiseworthy, and one of them is blameworthy. The two that are praiseworthy, that will draw us closer to Allah Azza wa Jal, the first one is the hope of the believer who does righteous deeds, praying, fasting, spending in charity, and so on and so forth, and having hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept his righteous deeds, provided that they do it with sincerity and in accordance to the Sunnah and the teaching of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is the first praiseworthy type of raja, hope. The second praiseworthy type of raja, the person who committed sins and turns back to Allah with remorse, with resolve to quit sinning. with the determination to do good in life and accompany that remorse and that repentance with righteous deeds in hope that Allah Azza wa Jalla will forgive his sins. That's praiseworthy. The third type, which is blameworthy, that will earn the person nothing but averting him away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing but Allah's wrath and anger, the one who commits sins, who is short in doing ibadat, he doesn't pray, he doesn't read Quran, he doesn't observe the things that Allah has enjoined on him, or indulges in things that Allah forbid on him, and when reminded, when called to return to Allah in repentance, he says, Ya Akhi, Allah is Ghafoor Rahim. Allah is all forgiving and the most merciful, and the most important thing is the heart. That's the most important thing. So please, Yani, it's my heart, you don't know what's in my heart. That's blameworthy. Because if he has true love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he would have observed what Allah has enjoined on him, and he would have resisted the temptation and stayed away from that which Allah Azza wa Jal forbade on him. And this is one of the calamities that prevailed in the Muslims' societies nowadays. That false hope, al-irja, that since Allah is Ghafoor Rahim, so do whatever you want to do of sinning. That's, you know, it's okay. Allah is Ghafoor Rahim. Sin as much as you wish, as one of the poem says, since you are coming to the one who is all forgiven. But Allah Azza wa Jalla, ya jama'ah, who told us that نَبِّعْ عِبَادِي أَنِّي أَنَا الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ, tell my slaves that I'm the one who is forgiven and merciful, also said وَأَنَّ عَذَابِي هُوَ الْعَذَابُ الْأَلِيمُ, also tell them that my torment is the most painful torment. So why remembering the first verse and ignoring the second one? So that's what we are, what we want of ourselves. We need to remind ourselves with the hope, with the mercy, with the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but also we need to balance it with fear. And here comes the third quality, with fear. Now, fear is very important in our life. Without it, the person, the one of us, will be inclined towards disobedience. We have a lot of temptation. We have a lot of desires and whims. If we set ourselves loose behind what we desire without having fear of Allah's punishment, then we will commit all kinds of sins. Therefore, true believers, brothers and sisters in Islam, maintain balance between these three qualities. The love of Allah is like the head of the bird, keeping us alive and attracted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The two wings of the hope and the fear keeps our iman in balance, hoping for Allah's reward, at the same time fearing Allah's punishment, so we remain steadfast till we meet Allah Azza wa Jalla. أسأل الله العظيم رب العرش العظيم أن يجعلنا من عباده الصالحين أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Brothers and sisters in Islam, with regard to the proportion of these three qualities in our life, love needs to be there all time. It's, as we said, the head of our faith. If we miss it, then faith will vanish. Now, regarding the hope and fear, most of the ulama said we need to maintain them in balance throughout our life, and that's what we observe in all the texts, the Quran and Sunnah. When the Prophet ﷺ came to visit a boy on the bed of death and asked him, how do you feel? How are you? And he said, I
I feel love towards Allah, hoping for His reward, but at the same time, I fear my sins. The Prophet ﷺ said, "Majtama'a," these two qualities, hoping of the reward of Allah at the same time, fearing one's sins, these two qualities, when they are combined in the heart of a believer, Allah Azza wa Jal in return will give the believer all that he hoped for and will protect him from all that he feared from. So we need to have these two qualities all the time in our heart. As we said, when we have too much of hope at the account of fear, we will indulge in sinning and thus a going astray. When a person have too much fear at the expense of hope, he may despair. And Allah Azza wa Jalla said, "La taqnatu min rahmatillah." Do not spare from the mercy of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. "Qul ya ibadiy alladhina asrafu ala anfusihim." Allah Azza wa Jalla said to his prophet, "O Muhammad, say to my slaves who committed so much of sins, so they wronged themselves a lot by sinning. La qul ya ibadiy alladhina asrafu ala anfusihim la taqnatu min rahmatillah innallaha yaghfiru adh-dhunuba jami'a." So when we have that hope, that belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in His mercy and grace, that irrespective of how much of sins we committed, when we turn to Allah, and that's an action, when we repent to Allah with sincerity, and that's the best of righteous deeds, proves our sincerity to Allah, Allah Azza wa Jal will receive us happily, will be so happy of us coming back to Him. But if a person despairs, "I did a lot of sins, a lot, I didn't leave anything, but I did that," then there is no hope for me. He continues to do sinning, and Satan will be very happy. You are doomed. So, since you are filthy in the swamp, so stay in the swamp, don't get out of it. And therefore, when we make da'wah to ourselves, when we make da'wah to the people, we need also to maintain balance between the two. What do I mean? We don't want to give the people false hope. "Guys, you are fine, you are doing fine, don't worry whatsoever," so they continue sinning without putting efforts to come to the right path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At the same time, it's not befitting, it's wrong to address people in a way as if they are doomed. You are doomed. You know the story of the two people from Bani Israel? As in authentic hadith, the Prophet ﷺ told about them. One of them was a person who was a worshipper, spending all of his time in worshipping Allah, praying, reciting the book of Allah, and so on and so forth. And the other one was the opposite, sinning day and night. And every time the worshipper sees that person sinning, he admonished him, "Detest, abstain, quit sinning." And that person ignoring the admonishment of the worshipper. Till he saw him one day sinning a lot, and the worshipper did a fatal mistake. A fatal mistake. One word, ya ikhwani, might cause the person to go astray and earns him Allah's wrath. That worshipper said that he swore by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah will not forgive for you and will not enter you Jannah. And Allah Azza wa Jal brought the two people before him, their souls, and said to the one who was sinning, "Go to the Jannah. Because I'm the Lord, I'm the God." And said to the worshipper, "Who told you that you have power over what's in my hand? Who told you that you have power? What's in my hand?" Allah Azza wa Jal was angry at him and entered him the hellfire. So brothers and sisters in Islam, we need to maintain a balance between hope in Allah's mercy, in Allah's rewards, in Allah's paradise. Equally important, we need to have fear of Allah's anger and Allah's wrath and Allah's punishment. Therefore, we need to guard our tongues. We need to guard our limbs. Let's always remember, نَبِّئْ عِبَادِي أَنِّي أَنَا الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Tell them that I'm the one who is all forgiving and the most merciful. But also let's remember with it, وَأَنَّ عَذَابِي هُوَ الْعَذَابُ الْأَلِيمُ. And my torment is the most painful torment. I beg of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to fix our hearts and fill up our hearts with love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with hope in His mercy, with fear of His punishment. So we remain steadfast till we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, while we are loving Allah, hoping His reward, and fearing His punishment. One last comment, the ulama said, some of the ulama said, that during the course of our life, when we are young, when we are youth, when we want life, we have desires, it's better to have more of fear than hope. Because when you are youthful, when you are strong, you demand things. You want, you know, to satisfy your desires, and you want to accept that temptation and so on and so forth. So more of fear will maintain our balance. When we are aged, when we are nearing the death, when we are on the deathbed nearing to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we need to have more of hope, more of raja, of Allah's mercy. That's very important, because shaitan comes to us at that last moment and is instilling in our hearts fear. So we say, we may despair from Allah's hope. And the Prophet ﷺ told us, in whatever state we die, whether that's we like to meet Allah, Allah Azza wa Jal will like meeting us. So we need at that moment, may Allah Azza wa Jal grant us steadfastness. We need at that moment to have a lot of hope in Allah's mercy. So we meet Allah Azza wa Jal at a state where we are liking and loving to meet Him. As-salullah al-azim, Rabbal arsh al-azim, أن يصلح لنا قلوبنا وأن يصلح لنا أعمالنا وأن يعيننا على البر والتقوى وأن يرزقنا طاعته آناء الليل وآناء النهار حتى نلقاه وهو عنا راض. اللهم آمين. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. فأقم الصلاة.
حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استقيم وقبلوا. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم وأنيبوا إلى ربكم وأسلموا له من قبل أن يأتيكم العذاب ثم لا تنصرون واتبعوا أحسن ما أنزل إليكم من ربكم من من قبل أن يأتيكم العذاب بغتة وأنتم لا تشعرون أن تقول نفس يا حسرة على ما فرطت في جنب الله وإن كنت لمن الساخرين أو تقول لو أن الله هداني لكنت من المحسنين أو تقول لو أن الله هداني لكنت من المتقين أو تقول حين ترى العذاب لو أن لي كرة فأكون من المحسنين بلى قد جاءتك آياتي فكذبت بها واستكبرت وكنت من الكافرين الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله 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 أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله استغفر الله استغفر الله